Počinje koktel vijem tamo, ostanite ovdje sa svojim kamerama, a mi ćemo vam posjeti.
Dame i gospodo, uvaženi gosti, dobar vam dan.
Marko Jokić je predsjedavajući upravnog odbora Zavoda za udžbenike i on je naš partner u izdavanju ovih udžbenika. Crnogorski izdanje na crnogorskom jeziku ovog zajedničkog projekta ovih zajedničkih historijskih udžbenika.
You can see we are looking to the variety of the region, which I think is quite important. But the language variety is not the only one.
Regiono, ali raznolikost jezika nije jedina važna stvar, već i raznolikost pa je proizlazi iz istorije. Mislim da je veoma bitno da idemo u dva pravca, da prihvatimo tu raznolikost, ali također da idemo u pravcu ka jednakosti, ka zajedničkom razumijevanju. Istorija je osnova tog zajedničkog.
Succeeded here in this work. May I tell you what the reason was? Some of you may know, forget it immediately, that there was a special coordinator of the Stability Pact for Southeast Europe. We did one event, which is also coming close to a jubilee, that was a business advisory council for Southeast Europe, for business
investment and so on.
So it's obvious that it is necessary to do it in common. But also on the other side, to get a better
druga stvar je što nam treba bolje međusobno kulturološko razumijevanje, da ljudi imaju kapacitet da žive u ovom susjedstvu. Znači, mi smo se tu fokusirali na problem u obrazovanju, posebno na tom boljem razumijevanju između država. Ako govorimo o ovom susjedstvu.
It's not necessary that you are joining his opinion, but you have to know which opinion he has. You have to know which way he has gone, because you are asking also for an understanding for your own way. I think it is a mutual process. So it came out, as we did some research on behalf of the Stability Pact, that the history books, by majority, are going to be a nightmare, because the presentation bear in different directions. If you are looking to the maps, to the historical maps, or if you are looking to the caricatures in the different history books, I think it's really hard. That's the one side. The other side is European Union. I think the real advantage of the integration process in general is to overcome the different perception of history, especially concerning that it is an argument against the other. I think everybody is speaking that the European integration process has started with
se bave procesom europske integracija, znači znaju da je Europska unija počela sa zajednicom za čelik i ugalj, a u suštini počela u stvari sa potrebom da se prevaziđe 300 godina ratova između Njemačke i Francuske. Mislim da je to bila osnovna stvar i to je vam uspješna priča Evropske unije. Ako pogledate istorijske čitanke u Evropi, možete da vidite da od 1945. godine nismo imali ratova i i još uvijek postoje određene tenzije, ali ipak i puno poštovanje između recimo predsjednika država Srbije, Hrvatske, Bosne, Crne Gore, i svi oni žale zbog onoga što se desilo, i to je veoma važna stvar da bi se bolje razumijeli. Dakle, veoma smo zadovoljni da ovo možemo predstaviti ovdje u Crnoj Gori i da prezentiramo ove istorijske čitanke za obuku nastavnika, jer moramo da obučimo nastavnike kako bi oni obučili kasnije studente i kako bi koristili te istorijske čitanke. Ja sam vam zadovoljan što sam sa vama danas ovdje, jer mogu da podvučem da je Crna Gora veoma pozitivan primjer uprkos. Ja sam recimo predsjedavajući ekonomskog foruma Europskog, dakle tu postoje određenih tenzija u okviru država regiona. Mislim da je Crna Gora uspjela da prevaziđe puno problema u tom smislu. Mislim da je očigledno, i to je argument koji je prevladavao u okviru Europske unije, da u Crnoj Gori ne postoje problema sa manjinama. Da, također Crna Gora nema problema ni sa susjedima i mislim da Crna Gora
I'm coming from Austria, as you may know. We had to settle our difficulties with Italians concerning South Tyrol, and we did it. It is a real success story, I may say. And we have a lot of benefits out of this situation. So far, I think what you are doing here is a kind of regional ownership, which is always requested. So the region is doing the things for itself, but it is right, and you can ask for some support also from European and other institutions. So far, many thanks to our partner and co-publisher, the State Textbook Publishing House. Many thanks to the Ministry of Education and Sports, and especially I want to thank Mr. Stjepović for being here to show this support. This is additional material, and it does not intend to replace actual textbooks. It is based on a new mythology, a multi-perspective approach to history teaching. I think this is the real aim of the Center for Democracy and Reconciliation, to contribute in this direction. May I tell you, it's not an easy job which we have to do, not only to bring the historians together, and I think I have a deep respect for the historians having done this work and coming together, it's an excellent group. But also, I think, first of all, there are a lot of prejudices existing what they are doing. They are rewriting the history in one or other direction and so on and so on. We have been several times under suspicion, which was not really justified, but so it happens. And I think we are surviving on this. And I think it is quite a good success story that it is accepted by the European Union. We are getting some money. Most of the money until now we had to find elsewhere to raise the money on different places, the United States, in European countries, and. I think it is a long list, and that's one of my responsibilities, quite a difficult job to do, because I think for some other things, maybe for highways you can get easier sometimes money is for education, which I think is a mistake. Because I think education is a highway to the future, if I'm allowed to say so. So far, we are in the preparatory stages for starting a similar set of books, which will look to the most traumatic period in the recent history, the wars of the 1990s in the former Yugoslavia. And I'm happy that Montenegro will be a part of that term from the beginning, because here you can see the very positive result of this development by all the difficulties which were existing. So again, I'm happy to join you here, and many thanks to all those who contributed. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Dr. Musek.
Zahvaljujem, doktore Busek, ambasadore Maurer, ekscelencije, dame i gospodo, čini mi izuzetno zadovoljstvo i čast što sam u prilici da se danas u ime vlade Crne Gore obratim na skupu posvećenom promociji crnogorske verzije istorijske čitanke. Projekat zajedničke istorije zemalja jugoistočne Evrope, koji uz podršku Evropske unije realizuje Centar za demokratiju i pomirenje jugoistočne Evrope, oko kojeg smo se okupili danas, rekao bih da je ne samo koristan, već i nužan. Koristan da bi svakog od učesnika pojedinačno, da svakog od učesnika pojedinačno učini boljim, a nužan zato što je preduslov našoj zajedničkoj evropskoj budućnosti. Raduje me što se Crna Gora pridružuje projektu koji je prepoznat u rezoluciji Evropskog parlamenta. Projektu koji uključuje više hiljada nastavnika, koji omogućava da se u porodici čitanki na engleskom, albanskom, bosanskom, hrvatskom, grčkom, makedonskom, srpskom i turskom nađe i crnogorskom. Istorija kao i društvo postaje sve inkluzivnija, demokratskija, globalizovanija. Razumijevanjem istorije postajemo svjesni šta treba izbjeći, šta treba poboljšati. Svako od nas je dio istorijskog trenutka u kojem živi i upravo nam istorijska iskustva omogućavaju da vršimo promjene neophodne da ovaj svijet učinimo boljim. Učenici naših srednjih škola, koristeći ove čitanke kao dodatne izvore literature, čitajući iste sadržaje, će biti u prilici da nauče više, ali da izvlače sopstvene zaključke o tome šta se kroz istoriju dešavalo. Istovremeno novo izdanje čitanke omogućit će učenicima u ostalih sedam zemalja da saznaju više o Crnoj Gori, o njenoj ulozi i bitisanju u period Otomanske imperije do Drugog svjetskog rata. Svoju veličinu država i narod pokazuju prelomnim istorijskim trenucima. Na način kako je to Marko Miljanov najbolje zapisao, znajući da sačuvaju sebe, ali i drugog od sebe. Upravo tako je Crna Gora postupila nakon jednog od najsvjetlijih datuma u svojoj istoriji, kada je prvi put međunarodno priznata na Berlinskom kongresu 1878. godine. Umjesto osvete, nakon dugih ratova protiv Turske, Crna Gora je znala da sačuva nehrišćansko stanovništvo i do jučerašnjeg protivnika prihvati kao svog partnera, kao ljude sa kojima će živjeti zajedno, obogaćujući sebe različitostima. Crna Gora nije nikada kao samostalna država ratovala protiv susjeda i drugih država, već samo protiv imperija. Živimo u građanskoj Crnoj Gori koja je danas takva upravo zbog toga što su je na taj način stvorile prethodne generacije. Stranice crnogorske istorije svjedoče požrtvovanost, herojstvo, hrabrost, jedinstvo i posvećenost. Naše djeca su svjedoci velikog istorijskog pregnuća Crne Gore, ali ona također moraju znati i zašto i kako se Crna Gora dogodila. Svjedoci su viševjekovne borbe za očuvanje i ostvarenje državnosti. Isto tako moraju znati zašto je Crna Gora vrijedna borbe. Moraju naučiti zašto da njeguju demokratske vrijednosti, kako naći granicu i pravu mjeru u kojoj istoriju treba prenijeti novoj generaciji. Prenoseći im ono što je potrebno da znaju i ono najvrijednije, ali istovremeno ne opterećujući mlade ljude repovima prošlosti i ne usađivati time lošu klicu starih vremena. Istorija se ne zaustavlja u udžbenicima, ona se nastavlja dok je svijeta i vijeka. Nije lako živjeti na prostorima gdje je svaka generacija naših predaka mogla biti vezana za pojedan sukob ili rat. Nažalost, čak i moja i naša. Uprkos toj činjenici i danas je prostor jugoistočne Europe jednako raznovrstan, etnički, kulturno, vjerski. I danas živimo jedni pored drugih, a rekao bih ponovo sve više jedni sa drugima. Spajale su nas i razdvajale različite ideologije, neke iznutra, neke spolja. Još od antičnih vremena bili smo raskrošće različitih civilizacija. To nas je sve skupo obogatilo, ali uticalo da na malom prostoru nastane mnogo različitosti, koje su nerijetko znale da dovedu do sukoba koji su se obnavljali kroz generacije, kako rekao sve, do ove naše. Kako ukazati na posebnost i istovremeno poslati poruku da je budućnost i bogatstvo, znati kako mnoštvo posebnosti utkati u jedinstveni i raznovrsni mozaik. Od nas Evropa očekuje da upravo taj harmonični mozaik jugoistočne Evrope uklopimo u onaj širi evropski koji se bazira na univerzalnim vrijednostima, a čiji je osnovni moto ujedinjeni u različitosti. Upravo u ovome jeste ujedno najveći izazov i najveća vrijednost ovog projekta. Da li smo mu dorasli? Mislim da jesmo. Da li nam je potrebna zajednička vodilja? Jeste i ka njoj smo se svi krećemo. Na tom putu naše različitosti dolaze do izražaja. One uslovljavaju da neko ide brže, neko malo sporije, ali nas sve spaja zajednički cilj da smo dio zajednice evropskih država i naroda. Relativno jednostavan, ali jasan cilj Evropske unije kojoj težimo je da se strahote rata nikad ne ponove. Stoga smo danas svjedoci jedne sofisticirane, nove Evrope. Složene i ambiciozne koja svoju ozbiljnost i stabilnost pokazuje i danas kada se hvata u koštac sa problemima koji joj prijete, ali istovremeno otvara svoje vrata i nama. Poštovane dame i gospodo, uvjeren sam da će naši učenici, koristeći istorijske čitanke, stičući znanje o narodima i događajima jugoistočne Europe ovog perioda prepoznati dostignuća, suočiti se sa greškama, izgrađujući zdrave odnose i stavove za dobrobit Crne Gore, ali i regiona kom pripada. Upravo sposobnost Crne Gore da kroz vijekove harmonizuje razlike, odoli iskušenjima i istovremeno promoviše multietičnost, multikulturalnost, multikonfesionalnost, najveći je kapital i doprinos koji kao država pružamo ovom projektu.
Dear Prime Minister, dear Mr. Busek, colleagues, ladies and gentlemen, when I look in the audience, I discover an old colleague which when we speak about history, I have to mention who is a real European, born in the Czech Republic, grew up in Austria, became a French, and is now a colleague in the Commission, and his name is Wenceslas Delobkowitz. So a family with a very important influence on history, and he is also responsible partly for this project we are here today. Now for me it's a great pleasure to be here for the presentation of this book on the history of Southeastern Europe, and as Mr. Busek said, the project of the European Union is in the first place a peace project. Also, at the moment we are just starting a new discussion for a new narrative of the European Union, because the young people in Europe, they have no relation anymore to the wars, and the Euro crisis brought up other problems which we have to face in the future. But I'm convinced for this area still peace, stability has to be in the forefront. Now, I didn't read what you have written about the role of the European Union up to now in this region. And I think, to be open, I think we have lost 20 years, because it could have been, if the history would have been different, that already Yugoslavia would have become a member of the European Union. Many people wanted it in Brussels, but unfortunately it did not work out. And now, in these 20 years, slowly, slowly, we are approaching to European integration. And I'm quite happy that the frontier with the European Union next year will become next to Montenegro. So I think this is a very step forward, that Croatia is now becoming a member of the European Union. And a second very important step is that Serbia got candidate status. And I myself was present last week when for the first time we had here in Danilovgrad a meeting, a regional meeting with the Western Balkan countries, and Serbia was sitting together with Kosovo, with the famous star now on the nameplate, and without any problems the discussions took place. So I think we are moving forward, and as Mr. Busek said, Montenegro itself is one of the best examples that if there is consensus in a country, political consensus supported by the people, a lot can be achieved. And if you look what Montenegro did now since it became independent, it's a real success story, and we are hopeful that Montenegro can start the accession negotiations in June, when the member states will have to decide on the basis of a report to be presented by the Commission. At the same time, we are already starting the so-called screening process, even before the negotiations are started. And this screening process will start in the area of the rule of law, which is seen as the core issue for stability, for development. And we hope that this is an approach which can convince our critical member states to start again a next round, which should include all countries which are still outstanding here in the region. Now, coming to the project of today, of course, teaching history is the most important, but of course the most important is to depict the history as it was, and that is of course in a region where there were wars just recently a very difficult issue, and therefore we are very grateful that this project have come now to an end, and has also produced a cooperation between the different countries of Southeastern Europe, and we hope that this will contribute to reconciliation and will contribute to overcome the problems of the past and to find consensus. It was already said, if you are in Montenegro, you have the feeling that it was always possible to live together, because here we don't have any problems with the minorities, and for us here in Montenegro it is very positive that we see that the cooperation between Albanians, Bosniaks, Croats, etc. Not a problem. So we hope that this project, which was funded by 980,000 euros, I have to mention, because we have always to justify vis-a-vis the European Parliament for what we spend our money and what impact it had. And we hope that this project will really contribute to overcome the problems of the past, and also that this project will have an influence on the school books in the different countries, because what we are doing, of course, is for the future of the people, and the children should learn what was really the history, and that they can then start thinking about living together as the others. Thank you very much for your
attention. Stoga smo se morali zapitati koliko se dobro poznajemo, i što da istorija jugoistočne Europe nije prosti zbir nacionalnih historija, negovanju kritičkih stavova kod učenika, otklanjanju mehaničkog učenja i oboljelo je
distančani osjećaj da objavi sve ono što doprinosi u napređenju.
A složit ćemo se, pohvali iz učenice su najbolja stručna potvrda uspješnosti ovakvih čitanja. Želimo i da nastavnici i učenici u Crnoj Gori saznaju više o državama i narodima iz jugoistočne Europe. Zahvaljujući kvalitetnim istorijskim izvorima interpretacije konfliktnih događaja između dvije ili nekoliko zemalja. Raspravu između autora i urednika su izazvali ne subjektivno.
Moj čas je meni jeste
I'm so sure.